Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi guys, how are you? Once again, I will continue regarding buffet calculation, buffet formula, how to build a buffet formula regarding buffet for the part 2. So kita bersambung untuk part number 2. Okay. Sini saya telah simpan dalam desktop. I already keep in desktop. So same also you all. If you keep in the everything you finish everything you keep inside the desktop, save as in the desktop, or you can save inside the thumb drive, so easy that the formula is not going lost. So kita buka balik yang kita buat tempoh hari, so you open back, so we continue for second part. So we see the, you see on top there F, start with F15, F15 ada start dengan F15. Okay, example lah, green lettuce, how much per person take? Based on ala kad costing, kita kena base balik pada pengiraan ala kad sendiri. Maybe 10 sen, 10 sen. I explain you later where you get this one. Fresh carrot maybe 5 sen. Cucumber maybe 0.05. Ini example lah. Fish maybe 10 sen. Okay. Lychee maybe 10. Longan maybe 10. Pineapple cube maybe 5 sen. White loaf maybe 10 sen. Wholemeal 10 sen. Chocolate donut. Chocolate donut maybe 25 sen. Is based on ala kad, based on. Okay, from here stop, you see. So chocolate donut 1 person cost for 1 person. Chocolate donut cost untuk satu orang, untuk satu orang makan 25 sen. So dia tengok macam mana I share dapat ni. How I get this one? I want to refill in this column. Go back. I see. Show you. Open the ala kad. Now open the ala kad. Calculation formula. This is my book. Already. This I see. You can see. This is my new book. My new project book. Bisa kuih donat, chocolate, kuih donat chocolate topping in Malay. This is my project book. So you can see that the calculation automatic, all in automatic. I put the formula there. So sesiapa yang beli buku chef ni, formula ni dah ada dah. Cuma nanti chef akan email kan sekali lagi formula untuk automatic ni. Anda cuma tukar di bahagian bahan-bahan, packaging size, inilah quantity, gram dengan cost per unit. Di bahagian ujung anda tak perlu ubah, jangan diusik. Seperti mana saya tunjuk lah. Like I tell you before, only you change this place only. Delete all this place, the total amount cost no need to disturb. Don't disturb. It's because it's a formula. This is my project book in Malaysia. In US already done. This on Malaysia. This on calculation. So ala kad calculation. You can see deh ala kad calculation. See. This one cost for 10 pack, based on 10 pack. This based on 10 pack. If one recipe 30 pieces, you can get 30 gram per 1 pieces. Then the calculation for the 30 pieces, on top there, see 30 pieces. So I get cost per pieces. Cost satu makanan, nanti nampak 25 sen. Di sini lah kita akan dapat tahu cost untuk satu makanan tu. From here you can know. See, round. This one cost for. This is cost for 30 pieces. 30 pieces of donut. 7.42. This one cost for 1 piece for donut. 25%. So because I make already the formula in the calculation automatic. So you can get from here the calculation for the 1 piece of donut. Same also bread. What? Chicken. Chicken api pin, nasi goreng, fried rice, fried kway teow, also same. Anything you put inside buffet category calculation, So you find out from the a la carte formula. Adik-adik akan dapat balik dari, anda boleh dapat balik daripada formula a la carte ni yang Syekh Hajar tempoh hari. Di situ ada cost untuk satu pieces. Ini buku Syekh, Syekh terangkan. Ini di bawah ni ada cara-cara. Ini gambar yang Syekh Syekh dah buat donat. Ini ada gambar food image. Ada cara-cara, the method. Di bawah ni ada food safety statement tentang keselamatan dalam dapur. Ni ada YouTube channel. Bila anda beli buku Syekh nanti, insya-Allah akan siap dalam tahun depan lah, insya-Allah. Dia akan link, anda boleh tengok link Kitchen Chef Diary Donut Yeast, Kitchen Chef Diary Donut Adunan, Kitchen Chef Diary Donut Maker. Dia ada part-part dia. Anda kalau boleh refer the link to YouTube balik. Ini dari segi makanan, food health, food harm dan food ill. Maksud dia keburukan dan kemudaratan sesebuah makanan yang kita ambil tu, sesuatu makanan yang kita ambil dan kebaikan dia. Macam contoh, kobis bulat ni, apa keburukan dia? High calorie. Sebenarnya apa kebaikan dia? Colon cancer, breast cancer, diabetes, kebaikan dia untuk orang sakit diabetes. Dan di sini ada info untuk macam tip lah. Dan sebelah sini ada allergic chata. Bagi orang yang ada alahan tu, dia tak boleh ambil apa ada dalam makan ni kan. Dalam donat ni bawang tak ada, macam bawang putih tidak ada, tepung gandum ya, tepung ada. Ni allergic, more to allergic. So this is my book. So I go to this one donut, this one go another one, chicken, ayam goreng serai, or lemongrass chicken. This is a recipe for lemongrass chicken. It's also my book already 50% ready, not ready yet. So you can see that down there, a big open, big scope for you. You can see down there, cost per one pieces, cost one pieces food, 166. This one you can get. Where you the source you can get to pay in the buffet kategori ya. Di sinilah di mana anda akan dapat, macam mana Syekh dapat memasukkan harga, jumlah harga ke sana. Kita ambil daripada rakat punya pengiraan, satu pieces, satu pack. Ini di sini 10 pack kan. Di sini one. Total one recipe RM13.28. This one one you divide by how many pack you get? Divide by 8, because this one based on 120 gram, divide by 8. So you get this. So far you understand where I get. I close back. Okay, open back the buffet. So I explain to you where I get the pricing there. Macam mana saya terangkan kepada anda, macam mana saya dapatkan harga yang itu. Okay, sekarang kita contoh. Fresh garden lettuce maybe 10 cents, 10 sen. Carrot maybe 5 sen. Nozzle titik 0.5, sebab kita dah masuk formula di situ, titik 0.5, itu mungkin 10 sen, 10 sen, lagi 10 sen. We put the price first, then we make formula there. 10 sen, 10 sen, maybe complete 10 sen, cocoa crunch maybe 50 sen. You see, it based on what your calculation back. I want to show you example how I get this one. Maybe 30 cent fresh milk based on 1% take, quite low, maybe 0.5 0.10 chocolate 0.25. Just now you see it, anda dah lihat tadi di mana saya dapat 25 sen untuk satu orang donut, chocolate donut. We based on one piece. One piece. Untuk seorang ambil makanan. Cruiser maybe Cruiser maybe 30 cent. Expensive little bit. Cruiser because of butter. Danish maybe 30 cent. Sopro maybe 50 cent. Sopro butter 10 cent. Plain porridge maybe 0.3. Just nasi, just porridge only, plain porridge, like soy sauce, 0.1 cent. 0.2. Boiled chicken maybe 10 cent. Fried shallot 0.03. 0.03 percent scale 0.2. Yellow another 10 cent. Chicken broth maybe 10. Ni anggaran saja saya letak ah. Anda kena cari sendiri, anda kena multiply sini, anda kena cari sendiri dari segi formula dulu lah. This one only roughly, make the example lah. You want to, you create the pricing, you must do a calculation one by one. It's a la carte. A la carte calculation. Like example, you finish noodle, how much noodle like yellow noodle with the chicken broth, something like that. Then the condiment, then you calculate everything, then you can get the price for one pack. Then you fill in. This one I make example only to make a formula for you all. For A in machine, 0.2 sen. Nasi lemak maybe 7 sen, 7 sen. Coconut rice, maybe 4 sen. Chicken maybe 1.6 ringgit. Just now I say ayam goreng serai, lemongrass chicken, one pack, one pieces, for one person take 1.60 sen. Bagi seorang ambil, tadi chef dah tunjuk kan, di ala carte punya costing, RM1.60. Maybe 50 sen. Breakfast sausage maybe 80 sen, 60 sen, maybe 60. Pancake, boy, potato maybe 30 sen. Chinese fried rice maybe 80 sen. Mee goreng, mee noodle maybe 70 sen. How you get there? Per person take maybe 45 sen or 50 sen. Egg, 50. You get there? Capsicum. Capsicum. Capsicum maybe 0.5. Sausage 0.5. I just roughly you know, better maybe 40 cent. Honey 30 cent. Strawberry 10 cent. 10 cent Prime break roti canai maybe 85 cent. Yang maybe 40 cent. Cut fruit maybe 30 cent. 30 cent. 40 cent. Cold drink, orange, maybe 0.80 cent. Coffee tea, maybe 50 cent. Tea, 30 cent. Okay. Everything you put ready, you can see. Now what you're doing, you want to calculate all total. Straight. Okay, you click your mouse from F15. Bawakan mata tikus anda ke F ruangan laluan 15. Tekan di sebelah kiri, tarik terus. You scroll down. Nanti where? Nanti food cost kategori. Isi food cost kategori. Leave it up, go finger your mouse arrow to formula. Click left side. Auto sum, click auto sum, sum. So, this is food cost for, is it food cost for the price for the buffet? 15 ringgit 80 cent. That's food cost. This one you know already, food cost for the buffet. So, di sini ada dah tahu, anda dah tahu food cost untuk harga makanan, jumlah harga makanan, jumlah harga makanan belum total lagi, kita tak campur dengan miscellaneous government tax lagi, RM15.88 based pada alakat punya pengiraan seorang makan, dan kita masukkan dulu satu. Sebab kita, anda kena faham, anda di luar sana kena faham, buffet ni memang kita nampak banyak, tapi berapa banyak kita boleh ambil? Kalau seorang ni kita berapa banyak kita boleh ambil? Sebab tu in hotel or in restaurant they play smart, they smart, they can put lot, because we eat with eyes first, kita makan dengan mata first, they put lot, so wow, so many item. So how many food you can take? Maybe 4, 5, 6, at least 10, that's finish. This one like this, you put okay, example you put how many, 20, 40, 50 type of food. But you can eat all? No, you cannot eat all. That's why this psychology. This one they need to put everything. That's why I say you the food cost for the hotel and restaurant regarding buffet about 35 to 50%. More higher, yes, higher, because you want to put all. Kita nak letakkan banyak, that's why the food cost tinggi. Jadi at the end kita nak ambil value. Satu company tu dia nak ambil value, nombor jumlah. Dia letak mic, kalau 100 orang datang, so dia dapat lah keuntungan. If they want to take volume only, if 100 people coming, take a buffet, so they make a profit there. If 10 people coming, sell those. Kalau 10 orang datang, rugilah. Inilah dia konsep dia, kita kena faham di situ. So di sini, saya mengajar anda buat formula, bagaimana kita dapat dia, macam mana kita nak buat pengiraan dia, dan bagaimana kita nak kira untuk buffet. Okay, miscellaneous. Okay, now you go to F101. Food cost time with food cost multiply with 10%. Okay, you go there. Click. You click right. Left. Left your mouse. Click. There. Click. Then you finger. You go finger your mouse to. You move your mouse. Your arrow. Go to home, find formula, find auto sum, click sum, this one equal. As you can see, equal sum. Maksudnya anda klikkan di bahagian F ni, F 101, arahkan anda punya tertikus arrow tu ke home, dan anda carikan formula, tekan formula dan tekan bahagian mana itu yang auto sum, tekan dia akan keluar begini. Klik dia, you can see kita boleh ambil bigger gitu ni. Ok, klik close. Food cost multiply with 10%. 10% lah, that means food cost is 100, this is category F100. You see? F100 lah. Tip multiply with 10%. Maksud dia F100 itu kategori food cost, F100 lah, dia punya formula, kali dengan 10%. So this one is miscellaneous. Miscellaneous ni macam what you want to call, like electric. Small lah. Okay. Anda boleh nampak di luar sana. Sekejap besarkan sedikit. Allah, lari pula. Biasalah kan. Okay, kita pelan-pelankan dia. So, computer share ni dia surface, rosak surface lah dia. Kadang-kadang dia berlari sikit. Electric. Masalah ni semua electric, water, gas. You can put labor cost also, can up to you. Guess. It's a miscellaneous. Government tax, you know lah. Government tax, government cukai kerajaan lah. Okay, now you go to miscellaneous, this category government tax. Government tax, full cost, this one, full cost multiply with 6%. Government tax formula dia, full cost dikali dengan 6%. 6%. Okey. Anda klikkan bawa ke tertikus sana di sini. Tekan di bahagian kiri. arahkan tertikus anda, arrow ke bahagian home, turun, cari bahagian formula, di sini pelan-pelan, tekan formula, arahkan ke bahagian auto sum, tekan sum, dia akan keluar formula ini. Tekankan tepi ini, klik di tepi, gunakan backspace, pelan-pelan, F berapa tadi? F 100, full cost, F 100, full cost. Nampak kan kalau di situ, tekan di papan kekunci ini, shift, tekan yang lepas, dan cari nombor 8 di atas angka 8, ada urut bintang, lepaskan shift anda, tekan nombor angka 6, dan sekali lagi shift 100. Keluarkan tertikau anda di luar, tekan N, tekan sebelah kanan atau kiri, ya. Ini akan dapat di situ. Anda dah angkat dia. Jumlah. Tarikkan dia. Kita dapatkan jumlah dia, keseluruhan jumlah. Next semula. Formula. Auto sum, sum. Auto full cost. See? You can see that? Okay, now. You want to change to another formula. To put the symbol. Okay. You finger your mouse. Go move to F100. Click. Scroll down. Leave it. Click on the right side. Then you can see the left, your right side, you can see out this format shell. Click on format shell. You can see there, general, you can up there, general, number, currency, accounting. General, number, currency, accounting. Click on accounting. Change this one. Put number 2 or number 1 up to you. Number 2 or number 1. Then click on symbol, go find to RM, ringgit Malaysia. It's Malaysia, Malaysia. If US, US. Find RM Malaysia. Then click OK. See? Full cost 15.88. Miscellaneous is add in. Miscellaneous add in 1.5. Government tax 95 sen, total full cost 18.42 ringgit. Nah, anda dapat di sini total full cost anda 15.88 ringgit. Miscellaneous ni tambahan ni, macam gas elektrik ni tambahan 1.50 ringgit, tambahan lagi dengan cukai kerajaan 95 sen. Jadi jumlah keseluruhan kos 18 ringgit 40 sen. So full cost persen, full cost persen, anda nampak sana kan? Full cost percent. Total full cost dibahagi dengan sale price, dikali dengan 100, dikali dengan 100. Di mana kita akan dapat total full cost. Ini total full cost 103 total full cost. Total full cost sale price, harga jualan. Harga jualan kita, kita tak masuk lagi harga jualan. Okey, harga jualan di sini kita masukkan harga jualan. Kata anda nak jual dalam buffet breakfast, 32 ringgit. Okey, harga jualan 32 ringgit. Aku formula saya share, aku masukkan formula. Formula share something RN. Dia kena perlahan-lahan, anda tak boleh ni laju, kena perlahan-lahan belajar. Okey, 32 ringgit, 32. Kita bagi color kan dia. Merah kan dia color dia. Ini seharga jualan. Begitu. Harga jualan juga ada di kategori F7. You can see. Now I explain in English. Food cost. They mean food cost. Total food cost. Total food cost is one. Total food cost. Di kategori F103. Divide by sale price. Sale price. F7 F7 dan then multiply with 100 divide by 100. Ha? Ya, aku dia. Go. Go to home. Find the formula. Formula. Then go to auto sum. Sum. You there? Okay. Big. Okay, now cut and the last corner there. Madam, eh berapa? Total pool cost 103 divide by sale price. Harga jualan F7. F7 multiply with 100. Then out from the box, see, out, can see there, divide by 100. Finger your, this one out from there, this one, total book cost 57%. Okay, now, later on we put, okay, profit, percentage, if 57, 100, subscribe by 57, then you calculate 100. Divide by 57, that means your profit is 43%. Jumlah kos ditolak, kos percentage ditolak dengan keuntungan percentage, anda akan dapat 43%. So, kita tengok di sini ya. Sekarang tadi saya gunakan calculator. Now you use a, this now use a calculator. Now use formula. Use 100% subscribe with food cost. That means 100% ditolak dengan ini food cost. Dan formula F104. Okay, klik home, formula auto sum, sum 100% subscribe, tolak, for in kategori F 04 put cost persen lah. F04, you can see that. Okay, 42. Yeah, correct lah. Just now I say 43, 42. Okay, now both of that, do kedua-dua sekali. Right click, find the format share. Go to percentage, find percentage. Change to 1. Go to OK, click OK. Okay, you can see 57% higher. You can lower a bit. You take up 1, 2, 3 items. I show you later. Home, we color first. Home, we go. Can see that? Now next profit. Next profit is sale price. Subscribe by total food cost. Sale price F7. F7. Sale price F7 subscribe with total full cost. Total full cost in category total full cost F03. Untuk harga net, harga keuntungan bersih ya. Total full cost dalam kategori sale price harga jualan F berapa tadi? F7 ditolak dengan total full cost F103. Okey. Klik home, formula, auto sum, sum. F7, tolak, F7, subscribe, you see, F7, sale price, yeah, you see the color there, I scroll down back. Total price, total full cost, F103. Can see, eh? Total full cost. Enter. So, profit is RM13. RM57. We put the formula there. You want to go, click. Left. Click right. Tekan kiri, tekan kanan. Di tertikus anda. Cari format share. Find the format share. Go to accounting. Go to symbol, you find symbol there. Tekan, click, then find the currency. currency Malaysia currency. Malaysia currency RM Malaysia. Okay, you see the net profit. Now the full cost. I mean color, yellow color. See, easy for you or people to see. 57% higher for the buffet category. If you want to lower the food cost, the price, you must give up 45 ringgit, something like 45 ringgit. You see, the price, the food cost be going down. Oh, one more thing is, oh, you remove one or two item from here, so you can get down the food cost. Ini food cost lah. Kalau food cost anda tinggi, anda boleh naikkan harga dia. Kalau anda tak nak naikkan harga harga jualan, anda buangkan satu dua barang di bahagian makanan ini lah. Bila anda kurangkan dia, jadi food cost akan turun lah. Itu cara-caranya lah. Ini saya tunjuk cara dia, formula lah. Sekarang kita nak isi di atas pula. Sebenarnya di atas bawah sama, cuma kita nak, kita senang lihat kan. Di atas kan kita senang lihat. Okey, total food cost. Sekarang kita nak diisikan di bahagian atas. Suara anda sama share. Allahu Akbar. Okay, total food cost. Total food cost bagi sale price. Total food cost. Total food cost adalah jumlah kos makanan. In English, total food cost. The formula you want to put, jumlah kos makanan. Total food cost divided by sale price. Multiply with 100 divided by 100. Total food cost kita dah ada bawah lah. Kategori apa? Kita kena catik lah. Kalau ada kertas, kena catik dari situ. Total food cost tu ada F103. Wait, get a pen. This one you need to write down in a paper, blank paper. Where the category total food cost? F104. Then go to sale price. Pergi ke sale price. Saya selit-selit pasal yang ni sama. F7 divide by F7, bahagi F7, multiply by 100, divide by 100. Okay, right click, format share. Oh, sorry. Go formula. Home, formula, auto sum, sum. F104, you can see down there, F104. Yes, total. Sorry, 103. Total food cost. No, not total food cost percent. Total food cost 103. Sorry, 103. 103 divided by F7 multiply by 100. Out from the box there, divide by 100. Total food cost. Jumlah kos makanan. Check back down. Yes, 40.9% total food cost. Jumlah kos makanan. Total food cost. Ratus keuntungan, 100 kos makanan, 100 kos makanan, food cost percent. 100 kos makanan, 100 kos makanan kita ambil, 100 kos makanan. Oh, okay, share pada. Kadang kita mistake sikit, kita kena betul balik, kita kurang balik. Sebab kadang-kadang dia mistake ni, dia dah. Kita kena melihat betul-betul formula. Sebab kita tak boleh lari dengan formula ni. Food cost. Tengok balik ya, food cost, see back, down. Food cost, the formula F003 F7, okay. Pukos. No, to Pukos, Pukos. Going to Formula. The home, to Sam. F103 divide by F7 multiply with 100. Okay, ni cost 40%. Oh, format share accounting. Sorry, percentage 40.9 total full cost percent. See, same down full cost percent, full cost percent. Color red bold. Profit percentage. So profit percentage, tengok di bawah, you can see down there the formula 100 divide by subscribe 100% subscribe with 104 is category full cost percent. 104 home formula auto sum 100% tolak F104. Back, make a format share. Percentage came to 1. Okay, 59.1%. You can see 59.1%. You can check down there. 59.1%. Okay, home. Okay, this one keuntungan basic, net profit. Net profit, the formula then, you go down. Net profit, take the formula then. F7, subscribe with F103. 103 mean total full cost. F7, F103. Old formula sum F7 sale price divide by F103, which category 103 is a total full cost. Net profit 26.57. So right click sebelah kanan anda tekan format share. Oh, accounting currency RM ringgit Malaysia. $29.96 Okey, anda dapat di sana keuntungan. Oh. Ini government tax. How government tax? See, government tax formula dia is 100 F100 total cost. Total cost full cost multiply with 6%. F100 multiply 6. Home formula F100 apply with 6%. Okay, change this one, click right, comment share, something. Malaysia, ringgit Malaysia. Example, I change this one. RM50. Is that all calculation is the remote bill, the automatic calculate. Oleh jumlah kos makanan, total food cost, total food cost on YouTube formula. Total food cost. Total food cost is divided. Okay, now I know it. Total food cost between this one 100 is this one, total food cost. Food cost add in miscellaneous, add in government tax, so it become a total food cost. This formula F100 F102. By doing this like this, you see, go to formula, go to auto sum, sum F100, go to like this, you see, F102. This total per cost, see, you can see down, total per cost 18.42. Right, click comment share accounting, go to find the currency, currency ringgit Malaysia, and so the formula is there, so down and up, up and down, atas and bawah anda boleh nampak formula. So example already done for you. This one already 90%. Come and finish to another 10% only. So example, the menu and cost buffet type of menu, buffet breakfast whatever, buffet lunch, buffet dinner, buffet high tea, buffet barbecue, date create by who? Then sale price is in English, man. Sale price is 50 ringgit. Harga jualan 50 ringgit satu kepala, 1% 50 ringgit. So total food cost is 18 ringgit. Jumlah kos percentage for the full cost 36%. Okay, 36. Okay, nice. Because the price is higher, the sale price higher. The margin for the percentage is 63. Keuntungan 63%. Keuntungan bersih, your profit is $31.6. Keuntungan bersih, I mean your net profit 31.6. Keuntungan bersih. If you change the price, so sale price is $20. Example, $20. You click this. This one, your full cost is $92. Very high, man. Still very high. Because you give too many food. That's why you must play smart. You must see. So like $35. $35. Buffet breakfast price. So the full cost is $52. Macam kita bagi RM35 harga. RM35, dia memang full cost RM50 lah. If we give RM35 the price for buffet breakfast, example, this one example. So the calculation is there is 50% lah. 50% full cost, 50% your margin, I mean your profit is net profit is 16. Di sini anda nampak macam mana pengiraan dia. If you want to change, if you want to little bit more up the sale, if you okay, like example you stick on the RM35, macam anda kekal kepada harga RM35 buffet breakfast, jadi makanan ni anda nak kurangkan dia food cost, you want to lower the food cost, what you doing, example like noodle corner you don't give, you make zero, don't give, you less the item. Maybe this item, one item you less two more item. Maybe waffles cheshire not give. Example, maybe the okay, you can see up there you back the cost is a little bit lower. You see 42%. This one another what to say. Lagi satu cara, another way, you want to stick the price RM35, $35, whatever you want to stick the price for the buffet breakfast, but you want to cost lower a bit. Maksudnya anda nak kekalkan pada harga RM35, jadi anda nak turun sedikit dia punya cost dan nak sedikit naikkan keuntungan. Jadi apa anda perlu boleh buat, anda kurangkan makanan di situ. This is one way, another one way. Otherwise you up the price lah. Otherwise you up the price for RM42 something. So the price may be change. Di sini anda nampak perbezaannya. I make small a bit. Chef buat kecil sedikit, anda boleh lihat sana. So harap anda dapat belajar dengan chef, insyaAllah. Dan satu lagi, ini adalah berkenaan dengan buffet . Kerip lah siapa ni. Chef lah . Right. Anda boleh tulis bagi anda, you can, this a crepe by me, myself. It's my own website. So, you can learn from step by step regarding about ala carte formula, how to calculate community about ala carte, about buffet formula, how to fit in everything about formula buffet. Purchasing, market purchasing, how to buy the item, and this one, the latest one regarding about sale price. You can see how many clips you sold, how many for the daily, for the monthly. So you can see from my website, from my YouTube, kitchenchefdiary.com, then you find kitchenchefdiary, then you tick buffet tutorial, what example buffet tutorial. Ala carte costing tutorial, you can find from there. It's slowly you learn from my YouTube. At least you can know. If you forget, you can rewind again. Only you share, like and subscribe my YouTube. So I give from my heart. And at least you help me a little bit to subscribe. So good for me also. Okay. Anyway, thanks. We continue another next episode. Then some more formula, and I make a drawing also. I will make a floor plan also. I want to teach you regarding the theory and the practical also. So di sini di platform chef, saya telah menghabiskan dari segi penerangan ala carte, costing ala carte, penerangan costing buffet untuk membuat buffet, kita penerangan buffet dari segi pembelian bahan-bahan market, bahan-bahan kering, bahan basah dan sebagainya, jumlah keseluruhan dan segi penjualan itu sendiri, berapa banyak kita jual, berapa harga kita dapat bagi harian dan bulanan. Anda boleh dapat formula di YouTube Chef, iaitu Kitchen Chef Diary. Dan anda tuliskan, buka ruangan YouTube, tuliskan Kitchen Chef Diary dan titik tulis cari tutorial food course ala carte, tutorial buffet, regarding buffet, tutorial purchasing barang-barang market, pembelian barang market, tutorial dari segi penjualan, sale purchase, dan lain-lain lagi lah. Anda boleh lihat sana dari segi teori dan praktikal. Harap anda jangan lupa subscribe, share dan like YouTube Chef. Dengan ilmu yang Allah bagi kepada saya ni, saya berkongsi dengan anda. Ada banyak lagi dari semasa ke semasa saya akan letakkan lagi dari segi formula tentang lain-lain lagi lah, formula tentang bagaimana kita nak drawing dari segi floor plan menggunakan komputer. Saya akan tunjuk dan latih anda, saya akan guide anda dari segi kita nak buat formula, dan banyak lagi lah, banyak lagi dari segi temperature, dari segi suhu, dari segi berbagainya lah, bersangkut-paut dengan bab kulineri. Apa diajar di hotel, anda akan dapat tahu dengan chef melalui ruangan YouTube chef. InsyaAllah saya akan berkongsi bersama anda dari segi teori dan praktikal. Okay, semoga kita berjumpa lagi. InsyaAllah, jangan lupa subscribe, share, like YouTube chef. Kita akan berjumpa lagi dalam episod yang akan datang lagi. Di sini chef dah dah selesaikan bab pengiraan bagi bahagian buffet. Harap anda di sana, di luar sana, belajar bersama chef. InsyaAllah apa yang kita share bagi ini ikhlas untuk generasi kita akan datang. Jangan lupa share, like, subscribe. Sama-sama kita membantu rakan-rakan kita di luar sana. Mudah-mudahan Allah membalas dengan kebaikan. Apa anda baik untuk satu kebaikan itu, Allah balas dengan kebaikan. Satu ilmu kita bagi kepada seseorang itu, 10 ilmu Allah akan ganda pada. Okey, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam selamat daripada saya. Arios amigos. Bye-bye.